So here we have a new question. This is a question that incorporates both dynamics and kinematics. It says a rocket blasts off from rest straight up, that's assuming, and it has a mass of 350 kilograms. The thrust force of the rocket is 3.2 times 10 to the power 4 newtons, so like 32,000 newtons or 32 kilonewtons. A, how high will it go in 10 seconds? And B, what will its velocity be at 10 seconds? Now you can tell that questions A and B are kinematics problems. But the only way we're going to get to a kinematics is through acceleration to dynamics. So dynamics and kinematics are connected through acceleration. So we're going to have to do the dynamics part first. And I'll draw the free body diagram here. Here's the rocket. And I'll say, okay, what are the forces on the rocket? So one of them is given, the thrust force. Now that thrust force is going to be up. And of course, there's also gravity on the rocket. Be careful, okay, so I'll just move this over a little bit. Sometimes you might see a graphic where you have a rocket that looks like this. And as soon as students see this, these flames coming out the backside of the rocket, some students mistakenly put the thrust force in the direction of the flames. This is wrong. Because if the thrust force was pushing the rocket down, then the rocket would never take off. Okay? So this is wrong. If you ever see those flames coming out the back, that is not the direction of the thrust force. Okay? So going back to our correct problem, the thrust force here is up. So what do? We say summation of the forces is equal to our net force. Then we say, well, let's take up as our positive direction. So we'll say thrust force minus Fg equals F net. Now we can substitute in some values here that we know. We can say thrust minus mg, which is force of gravity, equals ma. Now, let's solve for acceleration. Let's solve for it algebraically. So, I can then, let's start it up here. I can say thrust force divided by m minus mg divided by m equals A. So I've just simply divided the entire equation by M, and my M's cancel on the MA part. Now the M's cancel here as well, and I can now plug my values in that I know. So my thrust force is 3.2 10 to the power of 4 divided by 350 kilograms minus 9.8. And when I do this, I get a value of, so 81.6 meters per second squared. That's my acceleration. Okay? Now that I have my acceleration, I can now move over to my kinematics problems and say, hey, how high will it go? How high is, that's a delta D problem. So that's, I'll write down the variables that I'm looking for and also what I'm given. I know that it blasts off from the ground, so I know my initial velocity is zero. I don't know my final velocity, I'm gonna find that out in part B. But the other thing I know is the time is 10 seconds. And the other thing I know, which I've been able to calculate here, is that my acceleration is equal to 81.6. So when I look at this, I should be able to immediately recognize that of my three kinematics problems, equations, I need this one. And I know my initial velocity is zero, so this term disappears. And now I can have 1/2 81.6 times t squared. And that's going to give me 4,081 meters. Or I can say 4.08 kilometers. That is going to be the height. So in 10 seconds, this rocket has traveled 4 kilometers in altitude. Definitely possible in 10 seconds to go 4 kilometers. It's a very powerful rocket. Then the last question says, what will its velocity be at 10 seconds? So in this case, I would say, what's my final velocity? And in order to do this one, probably the easiest equation to use here would be this one. Again, since my initial velocity is zero, and I already have my acceleration, I would go 81.6 times 10 seconds, which is going to give me 816 meters per second. Now, that really doesn't mean a lot to me, so I'd like to convert this into kilometers per hour. And if you remember, the conversion factor is 3.6, and kilometer per hour is the bigger number. So if I now go 816 times 3.6, I get 2,938 kilometers per hour. And going from here to here, you just multiply by 3.6. Again, 3.6 is the conversion factor, which we've memorized, but just to say, kilometer per hour is the bigger number, so we're going to have to multiply. Now that's almost 3,000 kilometers per hour. This is definitely supersonic. And you know, after 10 seconds, by the way, just a heads up, we're not going to be able to put a human in this rocket. Why? Well, if you take a look at the acceleration here, we're at 81 meters per second. So that's like essentially 8 times, if you just make a guesstimate here and say, okay, if g is 10, which is about 9.8, that's 8 times the acceleration of gravity. That means if we put an astronaut in here, they're going to experience 8 g's. And that's really not good for a human. They're not going to be able to stay conscious at that type of an acceleration. So this is definitely an unmanned rocket. Okay? So hope this one was easy for you.